around the New Mexico State Fairgrounds in the beautiful city of Albuquerque in the wonderful state of New Mexico. Fresca's Productions, along with Corona Extra and Cedric Kushner Promotions, are happy to bring you Heavyweight Explosion. It'll be 10 rounds in the heavyweights. The judges for this particular bout will be Dan Cisneros, Rocky Burke, and Louis Bodenweiser. Your timekeepers are Terry McDowell and Linda Martinez, and your ringside physician, Dr. Milligan. Your referee in charge of tonight's bout is Tony Rosales. Introducing the combatants. First in the blue corner, he's currently ranked number 5 in the IBF. He weighed in at a slim trim, 227 pounds. He's wearing the black trunks with the gold trim. He has a professional record of 26 wins, 1 defeat, 17 knockouts. He's from Pretoria, South Africa, Corey Sanders. In the red corner, he weighed in at 207 pounds. He's wearing the red trunks with the yellow trim. He has a professional record of 29 wins, 13 losses, 2 draws, with an impressive 24 knockouts. He hails from Muhammad Ali's hometown, Louisville, Kentucky, James Pritchard.
All right, we're getting ready, but I want to clear up one thing real fast. Of course, that's not Tom McNeely fighting Mike Tyson, as I mentioned in the open. It's Peter McNeely, his son. Tom fought Floyd Patterson for the world title back in 1962. Feel compelled to make that announcement. And here we go. Round number one, scheduled 10-rounder. Corey Sanders, of course, southpaw. Comes into this fight 26-1, 17 KOs, and they've done a pretty good job of getting him back on track, Bob, since that upset knockout loss to Nate Tubbs back in May of 94.
No, they really have, and, you know, that's just what the doctor ordered when you have an upset. In the heavyweight division, you know, you got to throw it all out. You're dealing with punchers, and he had that setback, and they got him back on track. The Leon fight, get his confidence back, knockout of a couple-time former world champion, and you know, now they got James Pritchard, who it'll be interesting to see which one shows up, because James is a world-class fighter, a world contender in the cruiserweight division, fought a lot of tough heavyweights.
Sanders looking very sharp, a lot sharper than when I saw him last, which was back in April when he went 10 rounds in South Africa with Nikolai Copen. Looking very sharp. Oh, and he catches Pritchard walking in right there. He's had 3 straight wins now since the Tubbs loss. He stopped Carlos De Leon in 1 round. Then went 8 rounds with Gearing Lane, and 10 rounds with Nikolai Copen. Comes in at 26-1, 17 knockouts, ranked number 5 by the IBF in the world. And as we mentioned again in the open, with the way things are going to be shaking out, could wind up being number 1 at some point soon.
He really could, and a very deserving challenger for the new IBF title he would make. But you see him there, he's getting off his punches with good snap against Pritchard, who is a very quick cruiserweight and got good speed for a heavyweight. And rather than using a lot of lateral movement and run all over the place, Pritchard seems like he's going to hang right in there.
And he gets stabbed in the right. He's down.
He's hurt very badly. Clean punches by Corey Sanders. And I don't.
Referee Tony Rosales taking a good look as he's wheeling off the mandatory 8 count. Asks Pritchard to walk towards him. Pritchard does not look good. You got to stop this fight. It's over. A very, very sharp Corey Sanders greeted by in his corner as we take a look at Tony Rosales walking James Pritchard back to his corner. Pritchard's record drops to 29-14-2. Corey Sanders improves to 27-1, 18 KOs. We take a look there. Sanders' corner, that's former world champion Brian Mitchell patting him on the back, also from South Africa. Harold Volbrecht, also a ranked welterweight, fought Mark Breland for the title way back when, working the corner today of Corey Sanders. Sanders looking very sharp from the opening bell, and we take a look at the first knockdown here from round number one. It was a good right hand, sent Pritchard crumbling to the campus. Referee Tony Rosales takes a look here. Knockdown number two. Left, right, 3 unanswered shots, and down goes Pritchard again to 1 knee. And right away, a very good stoppage. Tony Rosales stops the fight right away. Brian Mitchell in the corner. corner there with his fellow countryman, Corey Sanders, ranked number 5 in the world coming into this fight. James Pritchard, of course, has been on the losing end of short knockouts. Is the losing end of the shortest world title fight in history, getting stopped in 24 seconds by James Waring, but has been on the winning end as well. And we're going to go up to the ring announcer, Mike Adams, with the official decision.
At 202, round number 1, winner by TKO, 18 knockouts, Corey Sanders.
Big win for Corey Sanders, improves to 27-1, 18 knockouts. Again, looking a lot sharper than his last outing against Nikolai Kopin. We're gonna go up to Bob Spagnuolo, who's got the number 5 heavyweight in the world in the ring. And up to you, Bob.
I've got him right here after a complete destruction of James Pritchard. How do you feel, Corey?
Very good, Bob. You know, I want a world title shot against Botha or Shield, so I want to work it and I want to get there. And I want to show people that I'm a real world champion.
I mean, we could tell early in the fight your punches were very crisp. We could feel them ourselves. And, you know, Pritchard's a very game competitor. We've seen him a lot going 10 rounds with guys like Tim Witherspoon and, you know, use a movement, but you cut him off, trapped him in the corner, and, I mean, finished him.
Yeah, you know, I saw him fight against Michael Moore, and he ran. So we thought he's going to run too. So I said to him, you know, I'm going to try to get close to him and just hit my throw my punches. I looked very sharp. I trained hard, and I'm ready to go again.
No, it was an excellent performance. What do you think, Harold?
Yeah, you know, like Corey trained for this fight, like he normally trains for most of his fights. But I think Corey is more motivated now because a couple of months ago, he was talking about fighting for the world title one day. Now he wants to win the world title, and that makes a difference, you know. So we're ready, and, you know, we hope to get a title shot early next year.
As we were talking about in the opening, too, with the way things are going in the heavyweight division with Botha, you know, fighting for the vacant title against the big German. I mean, things could really open up. You guys could be right in a mandatory situation.
Yeah, well, you know, Botha wouldn't be a problem for Corey Sanders because Corey fought him 4 times as an amateur, beat him once on points and knocked him out 3 times. So when Corey fights him, it'll be a knockout for him for the 4th time.
Not really worried about that matchup.
No, definitely not. You know, that's the fight we would like to get.
That's probably why you won't get it, but still, you know, you're in that position. A great win for you here today, and congratulations, fellas.
Thanks, Bob.
Thank you.
Back to you, Arn.
All right, thanks, Bob, and a very happy Corey Sanders, along with trainer Harold Volbrecht, improves to 27-1, 18 knockouts, looking for that world title shot. Bob said, not necessarily going to get the one that he wants, but we look forward to seeing Corey in a world title shot early next year, making a terrific move here after a disappointing loss to Nate Tubbs back in 94 for his 4th straight win. James Pritchard drops to 29-14-2, stopped in the 1st round. And I think he's got to do some careful consideration about